Hey guys, welcome to another tutorial video. In this tutorial video, I'm going to show you two things. So first off, how you can actually deploy a static HTML web app on Azure, and secondly, how you can use that web app to utilize CDN to load your websites faster. And you can do all of these and learn these in under 6 minutes. So let's go. So first off, you want to create what we call deployment credentials, and this is what you use for your FTP and also your local git. Now you can do everything in bash and also your terminal, but I just want to show you how it kind of looks like in the portal. Now we're actually creating a resource group for our web app, and I'm going to show you in the portal now that our resource group that we just created is actually there in the portal. But there's no resources inside because we haven't created them, so let's create a resource. Now, in order for you to be able to run your web app, you need somewhere to host and manage it. So we can use something called App Service. And today we're going to use the free tier so that it doesn't cost us any money to host our web app. But App Service can actually help you manage your mobile and also web and other apps as well. Now, if you refresh your resource group, voila, you see your App Service that you just created just now. So now you need sort of like a placeholder for your web app. So just run this command. Oops, little mistake. Give it some time and voila. So now that you have your placeholder for your web app, you need something called the deployment local git URL, which is up here. And this URL helps you push whatever git repository that you have on your local machine up to Azure. So let's go back to our local machine terminal and go to the directory that has our web app. So what you want to do is to have a connector between your local machine and also your Azure. So what you have to have is something called the git Azure remote with the deployment local git URL that I talked about earlier. And by using that, we can connect your local machine repository, your local repository to Azure, and you can just push it up. And done! You have your web app. So if you go back to your portal and get your web app URL, you can just see that your web app, you should be up and running perfectly. So now for the second part, we're going to talk about CDN. So if you go to your web app and you go under networking, you can enable what it's called the Azure CDN. Now, what CDN does to your website is basically they cache your static material on servers closer to your users. And on Azure, you can just create an endpoint. So it does sort of, you can think of it as having two web apps, but one is cached and one is not. So the Azure CDN endpoint should be so much faster than your original URL. And on Azure, we have three kinds of CDN offerings. We have Premium of Verizon, we have Premium of Verizon, and also Akamai as well. And the reason why Azure CDN is CDN is so much faster in general is because your static material is cached and servers closer to your users. And the reason why I hosted the website on West US is because it shows a better difference coming from Hong Kong. So if it's way so much faster going across the sea, you can see the difference in loading the material of your website. But CDN can also be used for streaming and non-cacheable objects on your website. So if you do gaming, streaming, if you do a lot of media, if you have a lot of videos and stuff like that, you can definitely utilize CDN. And if you add endpoints on Azure, you can actually choose how you want to optimize your website, whether it's from storage, cloud surface, or web app. You can use it for general web delivery, you can use it for gaming, multi-live streaming, and other things as well. So yeah, that's basically CDN, and it's very easy for you not only to deploy a web app on Azure, which is in a lot of ways free, depending on the tier that you choose, but CDN is also very much very easy to enable. So now we have our two endpoints, and I'm going to show you if you try and load it and inspect it on your browser, this one is your original endpoint, and it give it some time and it should load way slower. So for the original URL, it takes about 1 second to load, but the endpoint of the CDN, it takes way faster. And for this particular case, it takes about 300 milliseconds, which is way, way faster than the other one. Using just a very simple web app, you can see that CDN has so much benefit in terms of site loading. So that's it for today, guys. I hope that was helpful. And see you guys soon. Bye-bye.